Hey everybody, it's Tallboy here, and I had a comment on one of my videos on this 1978 Maytag, if I would make a video showing step by step how to use it, because the person just moved into a house and doesn't really know how to use this sort of machine, so they wanted to know if I could, you know, kind of go right through all the steps, how to load it, put detergent, change the settings, all that kind of stuff. And so I'm like, hey, that's pretty easy. I don't have much to wash, and this isn't really going to be a full cycle video, but it will be just kind of showing how all the controls work, and, you know, we'll start a wash. I'm not going to sit here and show the entire cycle, but so let me do this first. So let's take a look at the controls first. I'm going to take the camera off the tripod here for a second. If I can get it off. There we go. What we have for controls, this first set of buttons over here, this selects your wash cycle temperature and your rinse temperature. So the, like you see, the very first button here says warm, hot, and then warm. That means it's going to wash in hot water, and it's going to rinse in warm water. So that's how they all work. So this would be hot wash and cold rinse, warm wash with a cold rinse, cold wash with a cold rinse. Right? This stuff that I'm going to wash, we're going to do warm wash. So I'll push that button in. These buttons over here show the different types of cycles. For the most part, if you're just doing regular laundry, like t-shirts and jeans and things like that, you would go with a regular wash. Permanent press, they don't make a lot of permanent press stuff these days anymore, so that's really not much of a cycle that we use anymore. Delicate is, you know, if you had, if you're a woman and you had like lingerie or something and you wanted a delicate wash cycle, for because the clothes that you're washing are delicate, then you would use a delicate cycle. But we're going to use a regular cycle because I'm just washing a couple of towels and a sweatshirt. All right. And then these buttons over here, they show how big a load you're putting. How big the load is going to be that you're going to put in. I'm going to run this as a large load. It's not a very big load, but I'm just going to put it as large. It's always better to err on the side of being bigger than what you think, because if you don't have enough water in the machine, stuff doesn't agitate very well and doesn't get very clean. So the more water you have in there, and the more easy the clothes can circulate around, the more clean they're going to get. All right, the main dial is right here. This is the timer, so this is how you set the cycle. Right now it's set, I don't know if you can see in there, so it's set on off because it's come to the end of the cycle. If I go to try and grab it and turn it, the knob just spins because it's actually in the on position right now. Because the machine had been running and it came and it shut off here, but the whole dial is in the run mode. To make it so that you can change that, you have to push this knob in like that until it clicks. Now you can, it's, and the knob only turns one direction, it turns clockwise. All right, you can see this section right here is a soak cycle, so if you want to just fill up the tub with water and let your clothes soak, like if you had stains or something you wanted to soak out, you'd select how long you want the soak cycle to last, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15, 20, 25 minutes of just soaking your clothes. And then at the end it would go into a spin at the end and then stop. But we're not going to do a soak, we're going to do a wash. So I set it to 10 minutes there. That'll give me a 10 minutes worth of agitation in the wash cycle. All right. That is, it's going to give us 10 minutes worth of wash.
So now we need to put clothes in and detergent and stuff like that. And let me put the camera back on the tripod for a second and we'll be right back.
All right, so when you're ready to start putting clothes and stuff in the machine, this is what you do. You're supposed to put the detergent in first into the bottom of the empty tub, and there is nothing in the tub. As you can see, it's empty. And so what I'll do is, you can use liquid detergent, powdered detergent, pods, doesn't matter what you use to for detergent. But I'm going to, you just basically, whatever you use, you go by what it says on the package, how much detergent to use. So you put the detergent down in the bottom of the machine. And then you add your clothes to it. Let me get them together here real quick. One of the things you want to not do is you want to not cram that thing so full that nothing will move. You want to just load it kind of loosely, no higher than the top row of holes in the side of the basket. You can see the holes in there, I'm sure, if I zoom in a little. So yeah, you don't want to load it really much higher than the top row of holes in there, and you don't want to be putting stuff in and then cramming it down and then putting more stuff in and cramming it down, because you're going to overfill it and nothing will get clean. All right. So once we've got the clothes and stuff in there and we're ready to start the machine running, we can close the lid. Let me tip us back up here for a little bit and zoom in so we can see what we're doing. Okay. So we pushed the knob in order to set the timer to the 10 minutes for the wash cycle. Now in order to start it, you just pull the knob back out again. And it's not doing anything. Oh, okay, well, let's do this. I need to move it one more click, I think. There we go. Okay, I didn't move it quite far enough. And I set the timer, so you pull it out, it should start filling, which it is. And it should fill up to whatever the load level that we set to. I set it for a large load, so it should come up probably to about here or so with water. When it's extra large, it'll come right up to the top row of holes. While it's filling, I'll talk about the fabric softener dispenser cup. Your machine may or may not have this, but if your machine has this little cup that looks like this and sits right in the top of the agitator, then you've got a fabric softener dispenser. And so if we wanted to put some fabric softener in that, we can just, I've got some Suavitel here. Am I showing it? Yes, I guess so. Yeah, right there. I put about a half a cap full in. Just pour that right in the top. Now if your machine doesn't have that, then you have to look at using something like a downy ball, which is something like this. You just put the fabric softener in there and then you pull the top up until it locks in place, and then you throw that thing right in with the clothes. And when the washer goes into spin mode, the centrifugal force pops that that top back open again so the fabric softener can come out when the machine starts to refill for the rinse cycle. But we're almost there. A couple more seconds here, this should start washing. The clothes are moving around fairly freely in there. So they should be coming, you know, well clean in this cycle. Okay, as far as, you know, these machines run totally automatically. So once the machine starts, it's going to go through the wash cycle. It's going to drain and spin and do a spray rinse. And then it's going to immediately, upon that completing, it will go into a rinse mode where it will fill the tub back up with water and rinse the clothes, agitate the clothes for a few minutes to rinse the suds out of them, and then it will do another drain and a final spin. And it does that all on its own, provided that your, you know, machine is working properly. If your machine, you start it up and it fills up and does this, and then the timer, which is this thing back here, if that thing never advances, like you can see, we're on about 9 minutes now. I'll just leave it there for a second. We'll see, because when it, about every 30 seconds or a minute, it advances like one little click's worth. I'll let that sit there so you can see that it moves on its own. Yeah, it's usually about once every minute it moves a spot, and I don't know where it's at, how soon it's going to move, but probably pretty soon. There it goes. Okay, so it just moved to 8 minutes. So that's, you know, that should be operating. You know, if that doesn't move, then your machine has a problem. The timer motor is probably gone bad. So otherwise, you know, provided that it's moving on its own, it should be, should be able to get through the whole cycle on its own without any help. So I'll let this agitate, and when it gets a little bit closer to going into the spin mode, I'll come back. Or to basically draining and spinning and getting ready to do the rinse. And then we'll show you how that works. Okay, it's getting close to being the end of the wash cycle. But I just want to show you how the clothes are working in the, what they're doing in the washer. If you notice, they kind of come up from the outside edge, and then they move toward the agitator and then go back down. You should see that. If your clothes aren't doing that when you're washing them, then you've got it too full, or you don't have your water level set high enough. Clothes need to be able to turn over like that. They call that turnover. And it doesn't have to be as fast as this, but because I only have like three things in there, so it's turning over pretty quick. But like if you had like four or five pairs of jeans or something in there, they would turn over, but it would be slower. But you would still be able to see, you know, your clothes coming up on the outside edge and then coming across the top and going back down right next to the agitator. That lets you know that you've got the right amount of water in there and not too many clothes. So let's take a look and see where we're at. We're down to 2 minutes left. Zoom in here again. about 2 minutes left. These machines, when they're done, it just stopped. This is normal. So when the machines reach the spot where it's in between the wash cycle and getting ready to start draining the tub of water and spinning the water out of the clothes, it's going to stop and pause like this for a minute. And that's totally normal. And it doesn't make any sound when it's doing it. It's just waiting for the timer. It's waiting for that 1 minute gap between every time the timer advances. So it advances once and then stops the machine, and then a minute later it advances another time and starts it spinning. So don't be worried if it stops like this and it doesn't seem like it's doing anything. It just takes a minute for it to get on to the next step in its program. It should start spinning just any second here now. There we go. It's in the process of draining and spinning. These machines spin and drain at the same time. That's normal. Next thing that's going to happen now is it's going to start a spray rinse. That will happen in just a minute here or so, and the spray rinse will run for about a minute. It just kind of helps to get some of the extra suds out of the clothes before it actually goes into the full deep rinse cycle. Spray rinse coming in. We can see it. Sprays in kind of off over on this side here. Okay, that's the end of the spray rinse. It's going to continue to spin for another minute or two, and then it will stop and refill with water. Timer here as it's going along. See, it's a coming up on the rinse. It's right at the end of that first spin cycle. So the next time it advances, it right now, it should stop and start filling up with it. Yep, it stopped and it should start filling. Yep. There it is. So it's going to refill. Right now, because what we had it set at, we had it set for a warm wash with a cold rinse, so it's filling with cold water. And I will just kind of pause this while it's filling, because this is kind of boring, and we'll be right back. Okay, it's getting close to being full. You can see. So it should start agitating here and within the next minute or so. Mode. And it will agitate for a couple minutes or so, and then it will go into a final spin. Once again, once it stops agitating for the rinse, it's going to stop and do nothing for a minute before it starts the spin cycle. That's perfectly normal. Okay, yep, just stopped, so it's going to sit now for a minute.
A few moments later.
Okay, it just shut off, and so there's a couple things that I wanted to point out. Now, your machine may or may not have this. Like I said, I pointed out this fabric softener cup, but if your machine has that, then it's going to have this part, but it may not even have this part. This part here is a lint filter. You pull it out, there's nothing on it really to speak of. But you want to, if it has this part, you want to pull it out at the end of your cycle or before you put a load in and make sure there's no lint built up on the outside. You can just wipe it off and throw it away. The other thing that I want to mention too is this machine runs with the lid open. Your machine most likely will not run with the lid open because I've deactivated the lid switch. And if I can get my camera out of the tripod again here for just a second. The lid switch is right back here in the very back, right under the control knob. And I've got mine set so that it thinks the lid is closed all the time. So that's how I can open it and have it run. Normally the way these machines work is you set this to start your wash and you pull the knob out to start it. And it'll start filling, but if you open the lid, it'll stop. It'll stop filling. If it's in the middle of the wash cycle and it's agitating and you open the lid, it'll stop. That's normal. That's the way the machines are supposed to work. Mine, just because I make videos of it for YouTube, I want to be able to run it with the lid open, so I have bypassed that lid switch. But that's perfectly normal. If you open the machine and it stops, or if you're turning it on and you're wondering why it won't run or whatever, close the lid, it'll start running.
Okay, and so hopefully that answers all your questions. Everything is done. Clothes are all spun out. They're ready to go in the dryer. And yeah, that's it. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave me a message in the comments, and I will do my best to try to answer it for you. So here's your video on the step-by-step process of how to run a load of wash through this machine. Thanks for watching. And for everybody else, take care. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.